Hi, I'm Callaway Cass, a senior design engineer at VPT. Today I want to talk about some of the protection features in our isolated DC-DC converters with a 28-volt input. In particular, I want to talk about soft start, undervoltage lockout, the overload current limit, and short circuit. First, I'm going to talk about soft start. Our converters use a voltage mode soft start such that when the converter turns on, the output voltage rises without chattering in a controlled manner with no overshoot. For this demo, we're going to look at the soft start of the DVTR 2805 single in particular. This is a 28 volt input, 5 volt output converter at 30 watts, so the full load is 6 amps. What I'm going to do is apply the 28 volt input under different load conditions, and we can watch the output voltage soft start on the scope. So first, I'm going to apply the 28 volt input voltage with no load on the converter. We can see a nice soft start waveform with no load. Vout comes up to 5 volts as expected. Now I will turn on the electronic load into a constant resistance mode, and we're going to turn on into a full load resistive load. Here again, we see a nice controlled soft start waveform with Vout rising in a controlled manner with no overshoot. And finally, I will set the load to a constant current mode. So the electronic load is set right now for 6 amps constant current, and I'll apply 28 volts to the input of the converter, and we'll see it turn on into constant current load. And again, we see a nice soft start waveform with no overshoot. If you have a high capacitive load where you're using a large filter capacitor on the output of the converter, please refer to another video we have in the Technical Video Labs section of our website. The video is titled Startup Characteristics into High Capacitive Loads. Now we're going to talk about the undervoltage lockout feature. This is common on all our 28 volt input isolated DC-DC converters. I have a DVTR 2815 single and a benchtop power supply to provide the input voltage and an electronic load, so it will be loaded full load when it turns on. And what I'm going to do is turn up the input voltage, and we can watch as the converter starts off, and as the input voltage comes high enough to release the undervoltage lockout circuit, we'll see the output of the converter turn on. On the scope here, the blue waveform will be the input voltage and yellow will be the output. Both will be 2 volts per division on the vertical scale. So as I turn on the input voltage and slowly bring it up, we see the converter stays locked out when the input voltage is too low to run. The minimum input voltage for the DVTR is 15 volts, so the undervoltage lockout is set such that it should turn on typically about 1 volt below there. As the input voltage approaches 14 volts, we now see that the output of the converter is enabled and the converter turns on and runs. Now, in order to prevent any chatter at turn on and turn off, we have about 1 volt of hysteresis built into the undervoltage lockout circuit, such that as I lower the input voltage, it won't turn off until the input voltage is down to about 13 volts, which we see right there. As the input voltage slowly decreased and reached 13 volts, then the converter turned off. Now I'd like to talk about overload and short circuit protection. All of our isolated DC-DC converters have overload current protection that is not a hiccup mode control, but is actually a continuous output current regulation. We have another video on this done by Jeremy Farrell called Overload Protection. What I want to show today is what happens when a short circuit is applied to the output. I'm going to apply a short circuit to the output of this DVTR 2815S, and we're going to look at what the output voltage and the output current does in the transient when the short circuit is applied. So I'm going to turn on this converter and load it with its full load of 2.67 amps. On the screen in yellow, we're going to see the output voltage at 5 volts per division. And in green, we're going to see the output current at 2 amps per division. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and apply the short circuit. Now here we see, before I apply the short circuit, the converter output voltage was up to 15 volts running its full load at 2.67 amps, and then I apply the short circuit. This large initial spike in the output current is due to the output capacitive filter of the converter dumping its energy into the load. So right when the load shorts, the output capacitors of the filter dump their energy and causing the large current spike. After that, we see this plateau in the output current for about 500 microseconds. This is actually the input current being limited by our cycle-by-cycle current limit. We have a delay before the output current limit takes over, and this filters out any glitches or short transients on the output from inadvertently tripping the output current limit. So after this 500 microsecond delay in this case, now the output current limit takes over, and the output current comes down to about 3.5 amps, where it's regulating 3.5 amps with the output voltage pulled way down. And after this short is removed, then the output voltage of the converter would come back up and continue to function as normal. So today I've talked about protection features of our isolated DC-DC converters, including soft start, undervoltage lockout, overload, and short circuit protection. Thank you for watching. Please keep up to date on our website, vptpower.com, and our YouTube channel.